Hi, AT from CNC at Home. I was going through some links that I had come across some while back about or of sites with projects that I thought might be fun to do. This particular one, Boxes PY, has just a ton of projects that would really be cool to do. So I started looking through the menu and I went under Boxes with Flex and I found Flexbook. Let's open that up. Can get a bigger view of it when we scroll down. This is what it looks like closed. This is what it looks like opened up. There's a little bit of room in here, and then this is living hinge, just lets this fold over, and this latch then keeps it closed. We get to control a bunch of settings for this. For mine, I wanted it bigger than this. 75 millimeters is pretty small. It's a small box, so I'm going to make that 125. And then for the height, I'm going to make that 200. My intention is to store dice in here and then potentially use it for making rolls, where I can just take dice and roll it in here. I will probably add some graphics or ornaments or something to the front of this once I get it put together, make sure that it works the way that I want to, then I will enhance upon it from there. This little reference box is something that I don't need. It's not part of the burn. It's just a reference. So I'll set that to zero, which turns that off. The inner corner loops, I'm going to turn that off as well. I don't need those to be loop corners. The way that that works, something you can look into. I'm just going to do a regular corner. Otherwise, I believe that's everything that I need. I'm using 3 millimeter. Craft plywood. I could change this to a variety of other outputs. SVG works really well within light burn, so I'm going to use that. So now that this is done, I'll go ahead and click download, and then we can open this up in light burn and see what it looks like. Here's what it looks like in light burn. These smaller pieces I've already rotated so they fit a little bit better on the screen for sure. My craft plywood really isn't going to burn all of this at one time. What I'm going to do is I'm going to burn this big piece out of a fairly fresh sheet. The sheet only has a couple things cut out of it, so there's plenty of room for this. I've done some measuring, and I should be able to get these two pieces on some scrap that I have. And this chunk of little pieces over here also can get that on a piece of scrap. These two pieces, not quite sure where those are going to come from yet. The big piece that I'm cutting here, there may be room to get these out of that as well. I'm hoping there will be. And then I'll get all these pieces put together. I didn't have to really do much of anything for this. I did change the shape that was in here. It came with an oval or not really an oval. It's a rectangle with rounded sides to it. I went ahead and did this as a hexagon, similar to what the image on the site looked like. I do need to make these setting changes here. I'm going to cut this on my LC50 Plus. So we'll get switched over to that. On my material library under plywood, 3 millimeter cut through. I'll go ahead and get that assigned to these layers because all of this gets cut out. So all these little pieces come out, but I'll do those first. Blue ones are on top, so those will get cut first. So all these internal things will get cut, and then the main pieces will get cut. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's go ahead and save this. Let's head over to the laser and see how these cut out. Here are all the pieces cut out. There were some issues with this. The hinge, as you can see here, is already broken, and that's just from me doing just a little bit of moving with it. So this is going to need, this whole piece is going to have to be redone. And I'm going to make this hinge a little stouter. I'll make the gap between these lines greater, and that should work well. I also found that these finger joints are too tight and they won't go together. I would need to go in and sand every single one of these fingers, or go in and sand out or file out every single one of these slots. So I'm going to reburn these as well. There's a parameter that I can set on here so that it won't be quite so exact. Playing around with the kerf setting and that sort of thing. I was able to kind of get these pieces put together. They just barely fit. They just really crinkly snapped into place. Get this one on here as well. Put it on upside down. Gotta get all these fingers going the same direction. Doesn't really matter since it doesn't fit. And then the last piece is this one. This is the tab that comes up through this slot for our locking mechanism. And what I want to do is show you how that works. It at least works in this scenario. So let's just get this last little finger in here. Yeah, it doesn't want to go in. So that's part of the problem, is these finger joints are just too, the slots maybe are too small. If we can get this one to go in. Well, I got it to go most of the way. There's still a little bit of a gap here, so it's not tight. I might be able to smack it with a hammer or something to get that to fit. Again, I'm remaking these pieces, so they should fit together a little bit nicer, and then we can use some glue to get them to adhere the way we want. All right, so that's not so bad, other than it doesn't fit. So I really could fix this up so that this frame part worked. The problem are all of these fingers, or all of these tabs, or both. That's just going to be a ton of work, and I'm just going to burn a new set. What I like to do is show you how this lock works. When this is all working correctly, this tab will come up through this slot, like so. If I can get it aligned, there we go. And then it sits up, you can see that. This funky looking piece, when it's in there, the mechanism has it slide in like so. So this piece slides back and forth and goes into that slot, locking this all in place. So let's see how that mechanism works. It's very simple. You basically have two of these little guys that look like the letter A. And there were two little pegs that got cut out. And what we can do is we can put those pegs into the holes. We can put them, there we go. And then the little A registers right on top of that. Like so. What that does is it gives this piece an area to slide back and forth. So it can basically go forward and backwards like that. And that's all it needs to do. If these were glued down, they wouldn't wiggle like that. But basically this just moves back and forth. These pieces just cover it up. So these cover up our little peg, and it covers up this tab sticking out so that it won't ever pop out. So that's in place. This then would slide back and forth real easily. This piece just gets glued on here, and it gives us something to put our finger into so that we can use it to slide this mechanism back and forth. So to see that mechanism in play, let's slide this piece back on. So this would... I have this backwards too, don't I? Oh well, it doesn't matter. These rounded edges are supposed to be back here like that. So I have these two pieces reversed. Not a big deal. For demonstration purposes, this will work fine. So our little locking tab comes through this slot. If I can get this lined up correctly, like so. And then our locking tab just slides in, just like that. Now these pieces are nice and stuck together. When this gets slid back like that, then this can open up. So that part at least seems to be working correctly. So it's a slick, simple little design and it works well. So that'll be really a cool thing when we get this all put together. All right, that's how this frame is supposed to be. And it would then, in theory, I wonder if I got a hammer and just pounded the snot out of this, if it would go in there. Regardless, the living hinge then is designed to wrap around this little arc or this little curve. But then this would just fold around like that. And then in theory, if it's all lined up correctly, that tab should fit down through that slot. And then our locking mechanism keeps the top part closed at least. So that's all proof of concept. That seems to work well. The size is really nice. I like this. This is about the size of a real book. Probably didn't need to be quite that thick, but I'm fine with that. Now we can see here how the hinge blew out. So we're getting that corrected. The new hinge will be stiffer, so it's really going to want to pop open when we get that done. The next thing will be to figure out what I want to do. If I want to put anything on the edges, if I want to put something on the inside of this, I'm pretty sure I'm going to want something on the cover. I'll want some sort of image, something for gaming, pictures of dice, that sort of stuff. Other than the hinge failure over here, this one turned out pretty well. It's really loose on that living hinge, so it folds real nicely. It fits together, it latches all the way back, and then I can latch it and it stays closed. I did not have to glue any of these side pieces on. The friction fit was so tight, I literally used a hammer to get those to go on. So I lined them up and pounded them in, and they're holding really well. The tolerancing on this is very tight. I don't like how they did these finger joints because they are so tight. There are some parameters you can adjust, and I made some adjustments for the second version of this. I also made an adjustment to how it did the living hinge, so it's not quite so fine and hopefully it's a little sturdier. The downside of that is it's not as flexible. So I guess I'd rather have it be less flexible and sturdier. This mechanism, what? Oh my goodness. Shouldn't say that was a hassle, but it's a hassle. Again, tolerances are too tight. I went through the downloaded file and found that the size of this opening versus the side of the thing that slid into it didn't match. This ended up being bigger, so it wasn't going to fit. And the same with this tab fitting through here. So I ended up making a few slight adjustments. One thing that this site does is it takes kerf into account when it's doing all of its dimensions, and I don't like it doing that. If I need to adjust for the kerf, for the width of my laser beam, I'll do that in Lightburn. Lightburn has an option to do that in the layer. You can set what your kerf is. All in all, I like the design. So this was the prototype. Figured out what works, what doesn't work. And then here's the final product. I did etch on the front. I'm going to use this as a dice box to hold dice in. So I used, we've seen this before, I've done coasters. The dice giveth and the dice taketh away. I also put the crossed swords with the 20 on it. I did not put anything on the back. And as you can hear, there's dice in there. I also went ahead and left the latch. You see that? I left the latch as an oval. Kind of torn. I liked this one. It kind of looks more like a dice, and it works well for latching and unlatching. But so does this one. As you can see, this has a lot more spring to it. You can't feel it on camera, obviously, but it has quite a lot of pushback when I'm trying to close this. So it should be sturdier. If we compare these two side by side, you can kind of see there's many more cuts in this than there are here. And that makes this one stiffer, a little stronger, makes this one more flexible, but also a little weaker. And there was a defect in the wood over here, and it didn't cut through, and that's part of why we had this issue. And there's really not a whole lot I can do about that. But there's plenty of room in here for a whole bunch of dice. I can have these dumped out and then actually make my rolls within this box. So if we have the dice off to the side, I can just take one of the 20s and give it a roll. How many takes do you think it'll take to get a 20? Give it a roll. 20! If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.
I can take the 20 side, give it a roll. 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 Should only take 20. Give it a roll. 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 20. Okay, how many takes was that? How many times did I have to roll that to get a 20? Should only take 20 rolls. Statistically. Plenty of room for all these dice. More dice than I ever really need.